Unlocking animal potential starts right at the beginning with the calf. We must get this aspect right, starting right from first colostrum right the way through. Epigenetics shows us that what we do in the first 60 days of the calf's life can permanently and irreversibly affect that animal's lifetime performance. It used to be thought that an animal's genes were its genes and affected its lifetime production, but epigenetics shows us that these genes can be switched on or switched off. One example is the queen bee. Queen bee is genetically identical to the worker bees, but is far, far bigger. The only difference being that at the larval stage, the queen bee received a lot more royal jelly. So that switched on the genes through epigenetics to develop the size of the queen bee. Similarly, what we do in the first 60 days of a calf's life, beginning with colostrum and the feeding regime on milk and the weaning process, can permanently and irreversibly affect that calf's lifetime performance and health and fertility. Here on the Larkins farm, in the fifth season of calving cows down, we can really see the effects of this attention to detail on the calf rearing system.
We're after learning a lot the last 4 or 5 years as regards calves and getting the heifers big enough. We know what to do now, but that was something that we didn't do right starting. It starts the minute the calf hits the ground.
Every calf, without fail, has to get them 3 litres of beasts, at least.
And another 12 hours later.
Regardless of what's going on or how busy the thing is, the calf has to get it, and preferably sucking. And to be fair now, very rarely we'd have to go in with the tube to give the calf the beasts.
So at Specialist Nutrition, when we set about realising the potential of an animal, the place we start is with the calf rearing programme. So we'd encourage everyone to take a look at their calf rearing system and some of the finer details that could be improved upon.